to be in contention in this game.
Faceoff win. Fearlessly into the goal crease goes Perry. Down goes Anderson. And it's a yard sale. The Toronto goaltender losing his stick in the process. Perry, I think, broke his. And Anderson is still down.
Freddie Anderson has a history of concussions from the side. And I'm not sure. Oh, it's a skate.
Yeah.
It's as he tumbled. Yeah, as he tumbled over top of the Toronto defender, Hainsey. Watch what happens. He leg whips him. And it's the left skate that comes back and catches Anderson in the head.
Ooh, wow, that's frightening. And Freddie is still down.
No, it's totally accidental.
Yeah, it's incidental. Perry, you could see, immediately went over to his former teammate to check on him. And I can't tell whether Anderson is cut or not. I wasn't certain there.
Looks like Curtis McElhinney might be coming in to replace Freddie Anderson. Let's take one more look at this. Does what he's supposed to do, aggressively attacks the goal crease. He actually slides to his left.
The battle earlier on, this isn't even the penalty. This was the battle that was starting, and Benning ends up losing his glove as Perry takes it right out of his hand.
And most scrubs. This is from game one. He's getting a drink of water. There's his Olympic teammate, Jeff Carter. Watch what he does with the water bottle here. As Carter's putting the tape back, Perry fills his glove up with water. And Carter doesn't realize until he gets his hand in there, and he just tells the linesman basically what a clown this guy is.
Johansson unable to make the play. Getzlaf. Backhands on for Corey Perry. Perry from deep in Jackets territory. Bolesky. Bolesky, who's played on this line previously. Another penalty upcoming. And play whistled down. An elbowing call here will give Anaheim their fifth power play.
And it was in the near side corner to the left of Sergei Bobrovsky. Corey Perry immediately grabbed his head after he got a hit. David Savard isn't agreeing that it was such a high hit. We'll take a look at it here. Crowd also not agreeing with the call. There you see, it's more of a forearm shiver.
Officials are conferring here.
Yeah, 2 minutes for roughing. Number 10 for Anaheim, 2 minutes for embellishment.
How about that?
They got it right. Look at the look on this guy's face. He cannot believe it.
So Chicago takes the icing. They put their top line. Anaheim puts the top line. Now you see number 10 there. Perry's got a hold of Hossa's stick, and he won't let go. Holds on to it, and Hossa says, okay, you want the stick? It's yours. So he says, just drop it.
Opening night. A shot from Corey Perry on Louis Domingue, and he goes right back after him.
Z ever comes out to play the puck. Perry comes in and catches him with a shoulder. Down he goes.
Perry stripped by Hossa from behind. And then Hossa hit hard by Perry. He's hurt. After Hossa took it away from the Anaheim forward, he got drilled in the back and has not gotten up.
That's like a cross-check in the kidneys from Corey Perry, and I just saw the very last end of it. Not a lot of protection between your shoulder pads and where your pants end, your midsection. Now watch 81. Great steal. Gets it up ice, and as he's exposed, yeah, there's the cross check. Your kidneys are back there, your spleen. And that's why Hossa went down in a hurry. A dangerous, dangerous play.
Corey Perry? More like Bori Perry?
Let's see why Semin didn't come on the ice and why the Hurricanes had just three players. You're getting ready to come on. Technically, I think he's in the field of play here. Oh, you see some intent there from the Anaheim player. I thought it was inadvertent. No, it wasn't. No call on the play.
See my little 10 days saving my dumb rats. Don't call it impossible if you really.